Kunzang, Tobgay, Bhutia. I'm a former Mr. Sikkim 2018 and a former Rubaru Mr. India 2022. Today, it's an honor for me to be here as this is my first TED Talk and I'm glad to be speaking in front of amazing people right here. Yesterday, I was just telling myself that I want to give the best speech. So I was writing down a few notes. Then I realized I don't want to write, but today I'll speak. Whatever I'll speak from my heart. So, I'm glad to be here today. It's an honor, and it's an honor for me to be here today, talking in front of you all. So, what I bring to you all today is about my journey and experience in the field of fashion and modeling. But before I get started, I'd like to share a little bit about my childhood. I'm going to keep it very short and simple because I don't want to bore you guys with my childhood stories. So, ever since my childhood, I've been a very competitive child. 2002, I won my first gold medal in Taekwondo. During my high school days, I was a basketball school captain. I broke records in high jump and I was a complete athlete. But at the same time, I was a very, very shy kid. I could not speak in front of people. I was not confident enough to talk to people. And I wanted to let that fear of, I wanted to let go of that fear of public speaking. So in order for me to let go of that public speaking, I decided to take part in an elocution contest, which used to happen in our school annually. And I told my teacher I would like to take part. And then she told me, Kunzang, you can represent the class this time. So I was pretty happy. So she gave me the poem. I was practicing the poem for 20 days in front of 30 students in my class. I was confident that I might do well. And during the final day of our competition, we were pretty nervous. And when we all left to the auditorium, we were all waiting there. As my turn came and I walked on the stage towards the stage, I could see hundreds of people. So I'm kind of getting like a flashback today when I'm standing here. And once the spotlight hit me, hit on my face, I just blacked out. That's when I realized I not only have the fear of public speaking, but also I have stage fright. And I had to deal with these two issues for a very long time. And after my schooling got over, in the year of 2017. And during the end of 2017, one of my cousins called me up and told me there is this competition which is happening in Sikkim for the first time and you should participate. So I asked her what competition it is. So she told me it's Mr. Sikkim Manhunt and it's happening for the first time in Sikkim. And I was curious because I didn't know much about pageant at that moment. But I wanted to give it a shot. So I registered and then eventually the organizers called me up and they gave us a date. So after a couple of days, I went for the audition. And when I reached the audition venue, I could see hundreds of guys there waiting for the audition. The first thing that I did was I went and sat at the cornermost part of the room because I was a very nervous person and a shy kid. So I waited there for my turn and as they called out my name, I went and entered the audition room. I could see a panel of judges and it was my first time there me experiencing cameras. It was my first time there, encountering people, panel of judges and cameras facing towards my face. They asked me a couple of questions and I replied them. And And then they told me, like, Kunzang, in a couple of days, we'll let you know if you're selected. I went back home not knowing what to expect. I waited. And eventually, after 5 days of waiting, they called me up and they told me, you have been selected. And that is how my journey started in the field of modeling. And we were taken to Namchi for 15 days of our grooming session. And there I met a lot of experts, grooming experts. And that 15 days of grooming session completely changed my life, my views and perspective. And I met a lot of people there who gave me advices and helped me with my self-development. And we worked really hard for that 15 days. Along with me, the other contestants, they worked really hard. And on the final day of our competition, we all were very nervous, but at the same time, we were excited too. So we congratulated, we wished each other well, all the participants. And then eventually, with all my hard work and dedication, I became the first ever Mr. Sikkim 2018. And after that, I got a lot of breakthroughs. I was the first guy from Sikkim to represent in East India Fashion Week, which was held in Guwahati, Assam. And then I was invited to Malinda Fashion Week, which was in Thailand, which was a very famous fashion week. There I got to meet a lot of celebrities from Thailand. There I got to interact with a lot of actors who shared their views and perspective about international perspective of modeling. And at the same time, with the help of my title, I even supported the animal welfare, because that is what I love. I love animals, I love dogs. So with all my title, whatever I won, I supported animal organizations. And I did a lot of shoots, commercial shoots. And during the year 2002, which is last year, I got a call from my organizers telling me, Kunzang, that this time you'll have to represent yourself in the national pageant, which was Rubaru Mr. India. As soon as I heard that, I was pretty excited, but at the same time, nervous too. So they gave me the forms, and so I filled the form and give them back. And after a couple of days, there are about 45,000 candidates who participate in the contest. But out of which only 100 contestants were shortlisted. After 5 days, they called me up and told me that you have been selected. Firstly, I was very proud of myself that out of 45,000 candidates all over India, I was one of the guys from Northeast to be selected. I was proud. I told my friends and families. They congratulated me. So we had to work. We had a grooming session again for about 7 months. That's when I worked really hard. I used to wake by 5:30 in the morning. I used to hit the gym. I used to work out for 2 hours. And again, after that, go back home, prepare my diet, and then leave for work. Come in the evening, again, go for basketball practice, because I was in one of the basketball teams in Sikkim as well. So I was disciplined for about 7 months. I was depressed at the same time because, like any other youngsters, I was also wanting to have junk food. But again, I kept telling myself, you know, that the competition is everything to me. I have to work really hard for that. So after months and months of training, I was mentally and physically prepared for the competition. And before leaving the competition, I got the opportunity to meet our Honorable CM, Sri P.S. Kolitama. He invited me to his residence and we interacted for an hour and so. I shared my views and perspective to him about the modeling opportunities in Sikkim and how we can uplift our coming generation. He was very positive and he was very supportive, and he supported me and throughout my entire journey, which even boosted my confidence during the competition. And after my preparation, we had to leave to Chennai for a competition. So I was really excited, at the same time nervous. My friends and family, they wished me well, and I left for the competition. And as soon as I reached Chennai, as we were heading towards the hotel, we were staying in a 5-star hotel then, because the competition was being held there. The first thing I noticed out there, there were sports cars which was lined up outside the hotel. The moment I saw the sports cars, I just came out of the vehicle and then I didn't even care about my luggage. I went and started taking picture. The person in charge there was kind enough to allow me to sit inside the vehicle as well. That's when I realized, oh, I'm going to achieve this one day. And then I got out of the car, went inside the hall. There I met all the rest of the contestants, 99 contestants, along with all the professionals. I was very nervous. I was very excited to see all of them. And our session started the very next day. It was really difficult. It was really tough, tougher than what I expected. We used to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. We used to have practice till 6 o'clock in the morning, the grooming practice. And from there, we again had a photo shoot going on to 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Then again shoots, then again sessions. And it went on for 3 days. On the fourth day of our semifinals, I was awarded as the best interview. And on the fifth day of our finals, only 20 contestants would be shortlisted. So we all were really nervous, scared at the same time. So on the final day of a competition, as we gave our best, all the 100 contestants were lined up. Only 20 contestants were to be chosen. And they started calling out names one by one. The first person, the second. So it went on to 16. So by the time they reached 16, I had a little bit of hope, because when I looked at my side, there were so many other contestants also wishing the same. And when they called out the 18th guy, I had lost my hope. I told myself, maybe this is the end. And they called out the 19th person. And eventually, the 20th guy they called out was me. And I was the last guy to be called out on the stage. And I was really proud of myself at that moment. So we got about like 5 to 10 minutes of break. We went backstage. Only 20 finalists were called upon the stage. We were excited. And we do not know who the winner is. We all were it was a very suspenseful moment. And we all were lined up and gave our best there. And the guy who became the last person to be selected, I won the first Rubaru Mr. India Grand International from Northeast. And eventually, I won the Rubaru Mr. India 2022 competition. Now I'll be representing my country next year in the year 2024, in the month of April. I'll be leaving for Brazil for my Grand International title. So what I'm sharing with you guys from my experience is that in life, our journey may be different. Our views and perspective may be different. But I'll tell you one thing. Our destination is the same. And in order to achieve that goal and dream, you must really work hard in life. You must face a lot of challenges. You must be focused, consistent, and most importantly, you must be content and humble with whatever you're doing. Because my dad used to tell me, son, no matter where you reach in life, no matter how successful you become or how rich or powerful you become, always know where you come from. And that has been there with me for a very long time. And with that, I would like to end. I'd like to tell you all one thing. We may have lots and lots of ups and downs in life, but I'll tell you one thing. These ups and downs in life will make us, will help us achieve what we want in our life. Thank you very much.